After a disappointing week in Provo, in the simulation and real life, the Bulldogs return home to take on the UTEP Miners. UTEP is forced to punt on their first drive, and Tech starts driving after this catch and run by Justin Henderson, followed by another catch and run, this time by Adrian Hardy for the score. Gavin Hardison's ability to escape the pocket helped the Miners drive down the field before a third down sack forces a field goal. Tech heads back down the field, and on third down in the red zone, Luke Anthony throws the ball right into the defender's hands, who luckily drops it, and Tech settles for a field goal. Hardison this time uses his arm to move the UTEP offense inside the 5-yard line, where he throws for only his second touchdown of the season. Tech wants to answer quickly, but is faced with a third down. But Luke is able to pick it up and more with his legs, then hands it off to Tucker for the score. But before the half, Hardison has his second passing touchdown of the day, thanks to this beauty. Tech tries to break the tie before the half, but stalls after a false start flag and a sack. And the Bulldogs get the ball first to start the second half, but come up just short on this third down and punt. Tech tries to hold the Miners to a field goal, but poor tackling on a third down results in a first. And a few plays later, Hardison takes the lead pretty much by himself. Now it's the Tech offense's turn, and for the second time tonight, Henderson breaks off a huge gain on a passing play. But Luke can't have Henderson have all the glory, and goes for a run himself, before finding Isaiah Graham for the equalizer. UTEP tries to take the lead again, but the field goal is just barely missed. Hopefully that won't come back to haunt them. Now with just over 2 minutes to go, Henderson is knocked out of bounds on a third down short of the first. Holtz can either go for it for the win, or punt and hope that UTEP doesn't score like they have so far on 4 of their 6 drives. And the Tech punt goes out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Hardison continues his torment of the defense by scrambling into field goal range with over 1.5 minutes left. But after Tech gets some stops, UTEP has a 3rd and 6. The plan here is to run the clock down, run one more play to try to get into the end zone, and call timeout if they don't before bringing out the kicker for the game winner. Not exactly what I would do in this situation, but you know, whatever. But that final play takes too long, and we're going to overtime. Yeah. The Miners get the ball first in OT, and Tech forces a field goal after this third down stop. But unfortunately, the Bulldogs are stopped on third down themselves after Juwan Johnson cuts his route short of the sticks. So after the field goal, we're going to a second overtime against UTEP. Who would have thought it? Tech gets the ball first this time and has more success after this option run by Henderson, then a bounce outside by Henderson for the score. UTEP needs a touchdown here to survive, and Tech only needs to make 2 stops after this Hardison run is stopped just short of the marker. But Deion Hankins makes picking up that first down look too easy. So now UTEP has 4 plays to get into the end zone to stay alive. On first down, the Tech defensive front is tired of Hardison's scrambles, and the defense bottles up Joshua Fields on the second down rushing attempt. A third down screen doesn't go any better, and now the Miners are down to their final play. On fourth down, Hardison drops back, finds a man well short of the end zone who drops the ball anyway, and Tech walks away with a 2-overtime, thrilling victory over UTEP, 34-27. Thank you.